Hi, this is Fred from Obedia, and I'm going to cover a subject today that we get asked about a lot, and that is, how do I turn my song into a file that I can use to burn a CD or upload to the internet? This is called audio export in Cubase 4 and in various other versions of Cubase. What you do is you go up to File, click on that, go down to Export, and choose Audio Mixdown. Let's see what happens. Now, the first message we get here is the left and right locators must be set. And what that's telling us is that our little marker locators up here are not set. And what that is this little guy up here, this little blue bar. Now, you can manually do this if you want to, or the safest way to do it, especially when you have things that might be out of the boundary of your display area, is to select all objects in the screen, in the main window. You can do that by lasso selecting, or simply if you hold down the key Control and hit A on your computer keyboard, that selects all. Now, once everything is selected, you're going to hit the letter P, as in Peter, on your computer keyboard, and that's going to automatically cause the markers to snap to the front left edge and the extreme right edge of your material. Now, here's one thing that you should be aware of when doing that. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. If a song has a hard end, and as in not a fade out, you'll notice that sometimes you have some things that have a little bit of reverb trail on the end. Let's have a listen to this right here. This is just the very end of a track. Okay, right there, there's some trailing off beeps and delays and things that I want to keep. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust this right marker right here out a little bit farther so that I can capture those last little trailing bits of reverb. Let's check that out and watch visually. There, we have those beeps fading out, and I'm pretty comfortable with that. So, now that we have our markers selected, I'm just going to zoom out for a look here. We're going to go to the File menu, click on that, go back to Export, choose Audio Mixdown. Now, the first thing Cubase wants to know is where this file is going to go. I'm going to put this on my desktop. So, I'm going to choose the file location output right here, and I'm going to click on Desktop. And I'm going to call this Song 1. Okay, so that tells Cubase what the name of the file is going to be and where it's going to go. Now, there are some other important settings here that you have to consider. Specifically for CD, things have to be stereo. The sample rate must be 44.100 or 44.1K. You'll see here in the drop-down menu that there are several other possibilities, but we want to stick with 44.1, and the bit depth must be 16. Again, this is for an audio CD. You have the option of creating a mono version of this, which a CD will not take, and splitting the channels, which is good for other kinds of software applications, but again, not for CD. So everything's set right here for CD. Let's try that. All right, now that that's done, I'm going to minimize Cubase, have a look on my desktop, and there is the file that I just created. That file can be used by any CD burning application to make a standard audio CD. Okay, thanks for watching, and be sure to visit Obedia.com for 24/7 training and tech support. Thanks.